What is up, everybody, and welcome back to my channel for another full day of eating. You might hear a little bit of something something in my throat here, in my voice. I have been sick for the last couple days. That's why I've been a little bit less active, but I'm excited to bring another full day of eating to you guys because I'm back to it. Yesterday was my first day back to the gym, so today I want to take you through everything that I eat to gain muscle as a vegan, but also I asked in the last episode if you guys want to see workout footage, and it was unanimous. You guys wanted to see it. So today I'm going to break down my biceps workout because that is one of the things that people ask the most, is how to get that peak on your biceps and how to get that split. So we're gonna get into that. But first, I wanna give an absolutely huge shout out to Purple Carrot for sponsoring this video. If you guys don't know about the service yet, it's a company that I've worked with for a really long time. It's been on the channel quite a few times and I really support the service. Basically, if you've heard of like a meal prep company, this is like meal prep 2.0. So generally you go on meal prep companies, you order the meal, they send it to you frozen. What Purple Carrot does is kind of a new way of it, is you choose the meals that you want. They have a bunch of different options like high protein or like 6-serving family meals. And then they'll send you a box with all of the ingredients and a very easy to follow pamphlet, kind of like a recipe book. So basically you'll say, okay, I want to make that Buddha bowl that they have this month. You open up the pamphlet, you take the food out, it gives you steps 1 through 5 or 6, something like that. You just follow them. It's super quick. At most it takes me like 10 minutes to prepare a meal, and then by the end of it you have a meal that is beyond what you are able to cook. It's beyond your culinary skills at the moment, but you just advanced yourself a little bit. And the cool thing is that these meals, these recipes, are actually created by a master chef, so it definitely expands your horizons. That's one of the reasons that I really like it. And the other reason is that for people who are new to veganism, or just people who don't have as much time, it can really help you take away the guesswork, take away the planning work. You just have the ingredients there, you have these recipes ready for you, it makes you eat healthy, and it also, again, expands your horizons so that you can revisit that in the future, because now you know new techniques, you know these new recipes, and you can go try that out yourself. Like I said, I'm a huge supporter of them. If you guys want to check them out, the link and the code will be below this video. You've already seen some b-roll of one of the meals that I made, but today I'm going to make one of their meals after my workout, which we're about to get into right now. But first, we're having a little bit of some breakfast. So I have my smoothie, my morning smoothie I have every day here. It's about 2 bananas, about a cup of pineapple, a little bit more of some strawberry, and then 2.5 cups of soy milk, 1 scoop of Vivo Life vanilla protein, then some cacao nibs, and some hemp hearts for the omegas. And that is it for this one. So then we're gonna drink a bunch of water, then we're gonna go to the gym.
Drink your water.
All right, it has been a while since we've jumped into the gym, so I'm excited to bring this to you guys today. Now, let's talk about biceps. Let's break it down. I think so many people want to know, what is the bicep exercise that gets me the peak that I want or the shape of the biceps that I want? But I would say it's not so much about exercises, because it is good to, you know, vary them a lot, but I'd say it's more about intention, the way you are actually performing the exercise, the amount of reps that you are doing, and the range of motion that you are using. So my bicep exercises always change every single week, but generally it's about 2 exercises that are directly hitting my biceps and 1 exercise that's hitting my forearms. I'm gonna start with standing barbell, and I like to use the standing barbell with an easy curl because I can do an outer grip where I'm kind of a little bit wider and hitting a different part of my bicep, and then when that tires out, I can move to the inner grip where I actually be able to pump out maybe a few extra reps, 3 or 4 reps, and that's just a good way to push myself past my failure point. The question everybody wants to know, how many reps should I do? It's important that you vary it. Sometimes you want to do heavy weights because you do want to increase the strength that you actually have, the amount of weight you can bear, the amount of weight you can use. But when you are pushing weights to weights that you haven't used before, you aren't going to be able to have exactly perfect form. So you are going to get there, kind of have not the best form, and then the next week you should be able to do that same heavier weight but with a little bit better form, and the next week a little better form, improve and improve and improve. But also you should be using a little bit lighter weights with higher reps so that you can get full range of motion, where you really stretch your bicep out and then you really come to the top of the curl and concentrate on squeezing and twisting your hand so that you really get that peak out and squeezing to the deepest part of your bicep. I know that kind of sounds crazy, but like visualize trying to get your bicep to cramp almost. That's a range of motion that when you're using heavy weights, you generally won't be able to hit. So it's important to hit both sides of it so that you can develop your bicep well. Next up, we're gonna do some preacher curls. Now you can either do this on a barbell preacher curl, but I've also been really enjoying one arm single dumbbell preacher curls. It's really fun as well. But with the preacher curl with the barbell, I'm gonna do a little bit heavier again, and it's gonna be a little bit less range of motion, and then I'm gonna lighten it up quite considerably and actually go to full lock. I let my arms fully extend and again come to the very top and squeeze hard.
Now, not necessarily every workout do you have to do some heavy, some light. You could do a full workout with just heavy, and the next workout could be completely light and higher reps. It doesn't really matter how you split it up, just the fact that you do at some point vary what you're doing with your biceps. Now, this is what everyone came for. How do you get the damn splits in your biceps? You've seen quite a few of us have it. I think John Venus, Nehemiah has it, I have it, and it's something that people always ask about, right? How do you get that split? What is the exercise? And again, it's not necessarily the exercise. I would say with the split, it more has to do with conditioning of your muscle, the maturity of your muscle. And so this just comes with time. When I first started lifting, I did not have a split in my biceps. And I was very, you know, I had very low body fat. It was very ripped. You could see everything, but I didn't have splits yet. Why? Because I just hadn't grown that density and maturity to my muscle. So I would say probably about 3 or 4 years ago is when the split started showing up. And that is, I've been in bodybuilding for about 10 years. So that's about 5-6 years into my lifting was when it started developing. And that's important to remember that as you keep lifting, even if you aren't making massive weight gains or strength gains, the way that your body looks will change with the years. And you'll notice this with people who have lifted for a lot longer that sometimes it kind of looks like their muscles are denser or have a little bit more graininess to them, like older guys. And that's just because they've been lifting for a really long time. Like I said, I always like to include some sort of forearm focused exercise. So I always kind of follow the ratio of 2-to-1 or 3-to-1 biceps to forearm ratio so that you're hitting forearms a little bit less. But I do think having big forearms really changes the way the whole arm looks. I think that's important. The final thing I do want to mention with biceps is that having lower body fat is going to massively, massively improve the way you look. Even if you have 2-inch smaller biceps than when you were bulking, you are going to look bigger with biceps that are ripped because you're going to see veins, you're going to see lines, and all that's going to make it look a lot stronger. Whereas if you have a little bit more body fat covering it, you aren't going to have that shape and you aren't going to see that peak quite as much. So there you have it, guys. There are my biceps tips. I would love if you guys would give me constructive criticism on this because I'd like to do more workout stuff. So what you liked, let me know. What you didn't like or what I should have included more of, let me know. Now let's get back to full day eating and let's eat some food. A little bit of spice on the jalapenos. You called it. That's bomb. Nailed it again, Purple Carrot. Guys, I just stopped at Trader Joe's, and if you have never heard of this, everything but the bagel sesame seasoning blend, I know it sounds simple, but it's so good. It's only $2, and I'm gonna show you what I'm about to do with it. All right, this is how you go from avocado toast in your kitchen to charging $14.99 at a restaurant. Just take that everything but the bagel, and just lightly sprinkle it all over the place, or heavily. I mean, yeah, maybe not too light. Ooh. And just like that, the real good snack right there. And then also, I just saw this at Trader Joe's, Miyoko's cream cheese. Now, I usually use Daiya, but I'm really excited because this actually wasn't super expensive. Usually it's like $9 for Miyoko. This was $5. So I'm gonna try it out right now. I really like that. It's definitely got that Miyoko's kind of cultured flavor thing going on. I can't lie, I do like the Daiya more, but that's completely personal preference. Time for me to eat, and then we will come back and eat some more.
Field that spreads from the neuron and can be detected by placing electrodes nearby, allowing recording of the information represented by a neuron.
Neurons, essentially, there's that whole idea, what if we were just a brain in a vat? This is often posed by philosophers, except we are a brain in a vat.
Dude. I love that you guys are really smart, so you'll be interested in this. Elon Musk is talking about Neuralink, which is a program that he's running where he's basically trying to make it so that they can implant something into your head where 1,000 little hairs, like little wires, are attached into your neurons so that then you can control like your iPhone, for example. You'll be able to like immediately think things instead of writing things. And this has always been kind of like a futuristic concept that he's talked about, but now he's actually just given a presentation where he's saying that by the end of 2020, he wants to have the first like 10 patients with this implanted in their brains.
That means by like, you know, another 5 years, this could be something that could be commercially on the market. What do you guys think about this? Like literally implanting something in your brain. Yeah, you'd be able to like do crazy stuff. Virtual reality. You guys could watch my videos and smell the food and taste it even. But would it be safe? Would you feel comfortable with it? I don't think I would feel comfortable with it. I gotta hear what you guys think about that though.
All right, the other thing that I really like about Purple Care is they send you this pamphlet that not only has the actual instructions to the stuff that you bought, but also it gives you a couple like quick recipes. And this one has kimchi in it, and I've never had kimchi and I've always wanted to try it. So we're gonna make this, I don't even know how to say that. Bibimbap? 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 We're gonna have some bibimbap. All right, this recipe couldn't be easier. Basically, I got a little bit over a cup of cooked brown rice and also a little bit of like what I had left of some black rice with like black lentils in there. So I have some long shredded carrots right here. Then I have some super thinly cut cucumbers right here. And I have some tempeh that's cubed and raw. And then I know a lot of you guys are gonna say, you gotta make your own. But this is the first time I've ever had kimchi in my entire life. So if I end up loving this, maybe I'll try making it on my own. And then it actually called for sweet chile sauce and I just got chili sauce. So this is probably a lot less sweet and a lot more spicy. But now we're just gonna make it all. Which basically just consists of me organizing this. Oh ladies, you know what time it is. This happens every time. Anytime I sit down with a little bit of food, the ladies always come. Yeah, we're getting water. I know what you're doing. You keep an eye on it. I know. I'll give you some food. So this is what we are looking like. Ooh, let me get that fork out of the way there. It looks pretty good. I kind of freaked out when I put the chili paste on there and it kind of got a little messy. So let's try this kimchi. I'm really excited to see how it is. I'm really hoping for the best here because everybody talks about kimchi and how much they love it. And I really want to become part of the group, but we're about to find out. I'm having a hard time identifying where the kimchi is. I'm gonna try a piece with a little less chili paste on it. All right, here we go. I think I like it. I can't really put my finger on it, what it tastes like, but I do like that. I think I'll grow to like that. I think I'm gonna try kimchi a few more times in a few different ways, and I'm actually really excited to try it. I'm gonna eat this up, and then we have one more meal. The notorious tofu fries, which so many of you have asked me for the recipe of once I put it on my Instagram story. Well, here's how you do the tofu fries. Last shot. Gotta get 2 to get 100. Hundred it is, baby. It's already recording and everything, yeah.
Dang.
You don't need to do anything else.
It's recording. Sick.
You know when you're like trying to look cool for YouTube, so you're like, this is the one, this one really matters. And then you don't get it. Anyways, I'm here with my three best friends in the entire world. Because Ian is leaving to Sacramento for his new job, man. I'm gonna miss you, bro.
You're doing it, baby.
Okay, now we're gonna dive into tofu fries. A lot of you guys have been asking about this, and it's actually extremely simple. So you're just gonna get a big block of extra firm tofu. The firmest you can get, it's gonna have the highest protein. It's gonna stay together the easiest. Turn it this way so that you are cutting it, and it's making perfectly long fry shapes. Like, do it all the way through. And then you're just gonna cut these into long fry segments, and there are your fries. All right, once you lay them out on a tray, you are just going to top them with chili powder, onion powder, and garlic powder. The heavier you can do, the better. You want it to be really thick because all of that is gonna crisp up really nicely in the oven, and it makes the tofu fry, what I feel like really makes it a fry because it's crunchy. Finally, I have 6 potatoes, and the way we are going to cut them is very simply just a quick vertical slice. And that slice right there makes it so that when it cooks in the oven, it doesn't explode, but makes it very easy when it comes out to peel it in half and just have 2 big chunks. So now this goes in the oven at 425 degrees for about an hour, 45 minutes to an hour. And then out the oven, and this is what they're looking like, super crispy. This is exactly how I like them, like this. The reason these tofu fries are better than like cubes or whatever else is because there's so much surface area that almost the entire piece of tofu gets crunchy, and there's only a little bit of the soft part in the inside. And then of course, these potatoes are all ready. They're super easy to bust open, just like that. And this is gonna all go on a plate with a bunch of ketchup, baby. But seriously guys, you absolutely need to try these tofu fries and I wanna hear what you guys think once you do. Thanks everybody for coming in here and checking out the video and thanks to Purple Care again for sponsoring. Make sure you check them out. I hope you guys enjoyed the workout footage in this video. If you do wanna see me continue incorporating workout footage, please let me know in the comments. It's how I know that you guys wanna see more of it. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. Team Beyond the Week, CT. Team Beyond the Week.